Hello everyone, this is Manjunath. Welcome back to the session. Chapter 9, Decision Making Statements. So, in this chapter, generally a program executes its statements from beginning to end. But not many program executes all their statements in strict order from beginning to end. Out of various types of program flow control statements, this chapter is going to discuss selection statements or decision-making statements. Dear students, every programming language provides some constructs which are necessary for it to be called as programming language. Let us talk about this programming construct briefly. So, in this session, we are going to learn on sequence construct, selection construct, and iteration construct. So, let's get started. In this slide, we are going to discuss on sequence construct. What is sequence construct? The sequence construct means the statement are being executed sequentially. You can see the arrow mark there. Statement 1, statement 2, and statement 3. So, every Java function execution begins with the first statement. Each statement in turn is executed. When the final statement of the function is executed, the function is done. This construct specifies the normal flow of control in a program and is a simplest one. Selection construct. So what is selection construct? So there will be two course of action. One course of action will be true and the second course of action will be false. If the condition true is satisfied, one course of action will be executed. If condition false is satisfied, another course of action will be performed. So selection statement is nothing but the selection construct means the execution of statements depending upon the condition. This construct is also called as decision construct because it helps in making decision about which set of statements to be executed. So let us deal with selection statements. The selection statements allows to choose the set of instructions for executing depending upon the expressions. Java provides three types of selection statements: if, if-else, and switch. In addition, in certain circumstances, question mark operator can be used as an alternative to if statement. The selection statements are also called conditional statements or decision statements. Now, let us see how does if statement work. Here, in this expression, the first table you can see int test is equal to 5. If this condition is true, in this first flower bracket and close flower bracket, the code will execute. In the second expression, if text expression is 5, if test is greater than 10. So if the condition is false in the first expression, then the second expression will be true. If the condition is true in the second expression, then the first expression will be false. This is how it works as if statement. So this is the if statement folder of BlueJay. Open. In this, you have to click on package. Once you click on package, you will enter into the BlueJay software. So here, so in this there are three programs. We are going to discuss on the first program, that is if statement. Open this icon, if statement, and maximize the window. Now this is the program we are going to discuss. So in this example, we have a variable named number. We have a variable named number and the value is 10. Check if number is greater than 0. So if the number is greater than 0, this statement should print. Else this statement should print. So 10 is greater than 0? Yes, it is. So the answer will be the number is positive. Now let us take a negative number and see what is the output. Okay, this is the negative number. Minus 5 is greater than 0. Yes, it is. Right? The answer will be, this statement is always executed. This is a basic simple if statement available in decision making statements. So, let us take one more example, that is if else. Let us maximize this window. In this program, the class name is if else, public static void main string arguments. So the data type is int and the variable is number and the value stored in that is 10. So check the number is greater than 0. If your number is greater than 0, then it should, if your number is greater than 0, then this statement should execute. Else, if the number is not greater than 0, else if the number is not greater than 0, then this statement should work. So the mechanism or the execution is, so the 10 is a positive number. So 10 is a positive number and the positive number is right, then this statement, that is the number is positive, will execute in the output terminal. If the number is not positive here, then the second statement, the number is not positive, will be printed. So in this statement, in this if else statement, there are conditions. The conditions are if and else. If the first condition is true, then the statement, the first statement should print. If the first condition is not true, automatically the statement will go to the next execution, that is else. So else will hold the second statement and the answer will be printed. In the previous example, we discussed with the if statement. Now the second example, we are discussing with the if else statement. So what is the difference between if and else? So if is a single condition, the condition will be true. But in if else condition, the first condition is false, then second condition should be true. If second condition is false, then the first condition should be true. Either any one condition should satisfy. This is if else statement. Let us go to the next section, that is switch statement. So in this program, we are using public static void main string arguments. This is the command used to pass the arguments. So I am using the data type as int and the variable name as week. I am inputting the value as 4. So what is 4 here? When I click or when I type the number 4, then automatically I should get the answer as Wednesday. Okay, let us start the program switch. So each case will denote you and give you a result. Whatever you have loaded in the double quotes is a statement. So each case will give you a relevant answer. So if I press 1, I should get Sunday. Okay, in between that, I am using a break to terminate the condition and go to the next condition. The next condition is case 2. Again, when I press case 2, Monday should print, followed by break. Then case 3, Tuesday should print. Case 4, Wednesday should print. Case 5, Thursday should print. Case 6, Friday should print. Case 7, Saturday should print. Suppose if you are inputting the number which is not available in the cases. For example, I have given the number from 1 to 7. In case you are inputting the number 8, then that condition is not been initialized. Output answer should be given. So I am giving the answer as invalid day, or you can give it as wrong input. Then at the end, plus day. So plus will invoke to the day where you have invoked here as day string. The number was 4. So once I get the number 4, automatically the switch case should start working and reach till the 4th position of this case and print the answer as Wednesday. So my dear students, let us compile this program and see the output. Compile. You can see at the bottom, class compile, no syntax error. It means that the program does not have any error. I'll close this application. Next, on this icon, I'll click on this icon, right click and void main string arguments. and the method has been passed in the main and click on OK. So the answer is the day is Wednesday. So the case was for in case I have inputted the statement as Wednesday. So the answer is the day is Wednesday. That's it for now. Thank you so much for watching.